This is the nucleus of the galaxy M87. And this is the first ever image of the galaxy.
When I saw the first image, I said, you know, wow, that's it.
It's a true, like a eureka moment in our scientific lives.
We're looking at this, the mystery of nature that has never uncovered, right? So.
So this is it. We've finally seen it. Scientists came up with this crazy idea in the 1930s, and they never imagined that one day we would actually see a black hole. It's so far only a few blurry splotches of light, and yet they contain so much information about the physics of the universe.
Yeah, I've been dreaming about this for 25 years. When I saw the first data, it was just some weird plot, and it looked like there could be a ring in there. I was like, oh my God, this is going to be interesting.
It looked pretty much what we were expecting, which was, for a theoretician, is always a dramatic moment when you have to compare what you spent years simulating with what actually nature is telling you.
This is just like kind of the beginning of being able to have another window into what black holes can tell us about our laws and physics. But already we've learned so much. So, you know, we didn't know, even though we had predicted that if you had a black hole that you would see this ring of light, we didn't know we were going to get that ring of light. And that's, you know, what we were kind of testing. We could have gotten just a blob. And so seeing that ring, and seeing a ring that has a size that is consistent with other measurements that have been done completely differently, I think that in itself, just being able to see that ring of light, being able to see that that ring exists, is huge.
We are also releasing this data that has from the Event Horizon Telescope that were used to create this image. So whoever out there has a, you know, alternative theory of gravity can just grab this data and test it.
Well, the big goal still is to make an image of the black hole in the center of our Milky Way, because it has a much better determined mass. And so we can do much better tests of general relativity. And we can also have other telescopes look at it. There are near-infrared interferometers which see gas going around it. So combining all this information will give us a much better image of how black holes actually work.
The picture we have seen today is only a first taste of what the Event Horizon Telescope can deliver. Already the data they have in the bag can produce a lot more information, for example, about what produces the jets, these enormous beams of light that we see coming out of the galaxy M87. Also, the team has collected a lot of data about another black hole, the one at the center of our own galaxy, and they haven't even started analyzing that. So stay tuned, there's a lot more to come.